Hey guys, welcome to KK Java Tutorials. In previous video tutorial, we have learned what is basically singleton design pattern and what are the different approaches to create a singleton design pattern. Just we had a theoretical discussion. In this video tutorial, we'll see first three approach to create a singleton design class using eager, static or lazy initialization. Yeah. So before proceeding for implementation, let's see what are the steps to create a basically singleton design pattern. As you know, there are various approaches to create a singleton class in Java, and all of them have the common basically steps or approaches. And these are the three steps you need to always keep in mind. First of all, you need to create a private constructor to restrict instantiation of class from other classes. Okay, this is the first step. Second step, you will have to create a private static variable for the same class that is only the instance of the class, right? So that means you are just declaring basically most of the approaches, you are just declaring a private static kind of variable for the same classes, right? And third approach, third steps, you have a you need to create a public static method, or you can say utility method, that returns the instance of the class, and this is the global access point for outer world to get the instance of the singleton class, right? Why public? Because you want the global access. Why static? Because directly you want to call with the help of class itself. You don't require class instantiation outside of the class, because you are just going to restrict the instantiation of this class outside of the basically class itself, right? So outer world cannot use new keyword or other approaches to create the instance of the singleton. So these are the basically three steps we need to follow in all the approaches to create a singleton. So now we will move to implement a singleton. So here is the Eclipse, and here I have already created a class. It's called singleton design pattern underscore one. So here I have created a plain class. It's called singleton. So first of all, we'll learn how to create a singleton using eager initialization. So in eager initialization, how we create a singleton, simply we need to create a private static. Here final keyword is basically you can say you will have to always specify final keyword when you do the basically kind of eager initialization. We'll discuss why. So now type of return type of this object would be singleton itself, and now let's say we'll give the instance equal to variable name. I have just given the instance, right? Now this is basically simply I'm just creating a singleton using eager initialization. Now we'll have to create a private constructor of this class so that outside of the class instance cannot be created, means other classes cannot create instance of this class. That's why we made constructor as private. Now finally we'll have to create a utility method or a static method, and that's the global point of this singleton, right? So public, because we want global. Static, because instantiation of this class is basically not possible from outside of the classes. So we want every class should call this method by class name itself. That's why this is static. Return type would be singleton itself, and you can give the any name of this method. So I would give get instance. Any name you can give. So I have given the get instance. Sorry. Get instance. And simply from here you need to return this created instance. Right? And we are done. So this is called eager initialization. So you need to keep in mind, first of all, you need to create a private static kind of variable. And there only you are just instantiation, doing the instantiation and initializing to this variable. You need to create a basically private constructor so that you can restrict other classes to instantiate this class, right? And finally, you need to create a public static method. From there, you are returning this instance, right? If I come to main method here, you can directly call this get instance method from here, right? So let's say this is singleton one, and you can call this method any number of times. Make sure that only one instance is created, and that's what we are. This is called singleton. So if I look into the hash code of method of this guy, sorry, and hash code of instance singleton two object, both should be same, right? That's the way to check whether if your class is singleton or not. Here you can see hash code of both objects are same. That means only one instance is created within the basically JVM, right? And this is called eager initialization, right? So in eager initialization, the instance of the class is created at the time of class loading itself. As you know, a static variable is always instantiated at the class loading time itself, right? So this is the easiest method to create a singleton class, but it has a drawback that singleton is created even though client application might not be using it, right? So that's the drawback. And if your singleton class is not using a lot of resources, this is the approach to create a singleton. But in most of the scenarios, singleton classes are created for the resources such as file system, database connection, etc., right? We should avoid the instantiation until and unless client calls the get instance method, right? This method does not provide any option for exception handling even, right? So here instantiation we have done, we cannot provide here try catch block, right? So always you will have to specify try catch block within the block or method, right? So this approach also not gives you privilege to handle the exception as well, right? So this is not even we consider as a best approach, and that's what we will look for the another approach that is called a static initialization. So just I'm copying pasting this class. Now I'm going to close this guy. I hope you understood singleton initialization, right? Single instantiation. Now here a little change in this class. Now we want a static initialization. So we required here a static block, right? So here we can have a static block, and this instantiation part we will remove into the static block. Yeah, and when you do a static block, then of course you can specify try catch block, right? You can specify try catch block over here. So here you can check if instance, sorry, instance equal to null, then only you need to create instance of this class, right? So this final keyword you will have to remove, right? Else you cannot assign a new instance over here, right? So this is called a static initialization, right? So what's the difference between previous method what we had created is called eager initialization. So a static block initialization implementation is similar to eager initialization, except that instance of the class is created in the static block and provides option for exception handling, right? Both approaches are same. Only difference is that when you use a static block initialization, then you got the basically opportunity to handle exception, right? You can put a try catch. But eager initialization, you do not have provision to provide a static block, right? So both eager initialization and a static block initialization creates the instance even before it's being used, and that is not the best practices to use, right? So in further section we will learn how to create singleton class that supports lazy initialization. Yeah, so I'm going to copy this guy and paste it one more time, and this is called, I'm going to close this guy, sorry, just close it. Okay, so let's close all the files and go to project 3. And here we'll see how we can create singleton using lazy initialization. So lazy initialization will copy paste this guy, okay, and within the class itself what we'll do, we will put this code. So in basically a static class itself, what we see, first of all we check whether instance is null, then only you are going to create a object of singleton, else same instance is going to return. And this is called basically lazy initialization, right? So lazy initialization method to implement singleton pattern creates the instance in the global access method. Here basically this implementation works fine in case of a single threaded environment, but when it comes to the multi-threaded systems, it can cause issues of multiple threads are inside the if block, right? If condition at the same time, it will destroy the singleton pattern, and both threads will create the different instances of the singleton class, right? So whatever approach till it, approach 1, 2, and 3, all are not thread safe, right? So here basically we are just putting a condition, right? If instance is not null, then go inside and create an object. So let's say in multi-threaded environment, there is possibility more than one thread can come inside the if block, right? So here just I have created a singleton instance within the same single line of code, but in real scenario you can have a lot of code inside this if block, right? Let's say first thread comes and that found instance is null, that go inside and doing the kind of initialization. Meanwhile another thread comes and first thread did not completed the instantiation yet, then second thread will find this instance is still null, that will go inside, and at the same time more than one thread will create the instance of the singleton. In that way, in multi-threaded environment, this singleton is not gonna work, singleton is going to break, right? So in next video tutorial we'll see how we can create basically singleton of our thread safe environment or a multi-threading environment. So here in this video tutorial we learn how to create singleton using eager, static and lazy initialization. We have seen what are the drawbacks and advantages, right? So that's all I have in this video tutorial, guys. I hope you enjoy learning this video, guys. Please subscribe my channel. In this video series we'll see all the design patterns implementation, right? So thank you so much for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.